Hey guys, IT Sisters here, back with another video. In this video, I'm gonna discuss about a cool thing introduced by Google a long, long ago. And that thing is called as OK Google, or it's traditionally called as Google Now Voice Assistant. This OK Google has a lot of features packed inside it which can be accessed using voice commands, but we are not utilizing the complete feature package of this thing. And the reason behind that is most of us are not aware of the voice commands supported by OK Google. So I refer some websites, blogs, documentations, and I collected most of the voice commands supported by OK Google. So with no further ado, let's have a look at most of the voice commands supported by Google's voice assistant, or whatever you call it as. Hey guys, if you're having a tech blog or tech website, then why use .com, .co, .net and other domains like that? You know, .com and .co and other domains are so mainstream, they are old-fashioned. If you're having a tech blog or tech website, then why not go for .tech domain extension? .tech domain extension is widely used by everyone in the world, even the popular tech stars, YouTube content creators, why not? Even CES now uses a .tech domain extension. If you want a .tech domain, go to get.tech and use the coupon code ITSSisters to grab your suit domain at just $2.99. Yes, just $2.99. To learn more, click the link in the video description. When we say the word Google, the thing which comes to everyone's mind is nothing but searching. And when it comes to OK Google voice assisted searching, it has an exclusive feature inside it. And for simplicity and convenience, I will be calling it as chain search. We'll be seeing about this chain search and synonym based search in the later part of the video. You can search like normal typing. Here you do the talking. Like if you want to know who's gonna host the 2020 Olympics, you just ask Google.
According to Olympics, on the evening of the 7th of September 2013, the president of the International Olympic Committee, Jacques Rogge, announced Tokyo as the host city of the 2020 Olympic Games.
That's it. Google returns the result. This is how you search normally using Google's voice assisted search thing. Coming to this chain search part, this chain search is nothing but continuous searching. For in case if you are searching for a person or a thing, like let us search for the President of the United States of America first. So,
Barack Obama.
If you want to search for his age or where he was born, or when he was born, who are his parents, things like that. You need not spell his full name and search for those things. Simply, you can give the voice command as, OK Google, how old is he?
He's 55 years old.
This is called a chain search facility. If you are wondering where this feature will be helpful, then let me bring you the scenario here. Let us ask Google, the director of the movie Revenant. So, OK Google, who is the director of the movie The Revenant?
Revenant was directed by Alejandro González Iñárritu.
And meaning no offense, this name is not that easy to spell. It's not that easy to spell, by the way. And in case if you wanna search about his age or where he was born or the awards he had won in the past or his other works and things like that, you need not spell the full name as Alejandro González Iñárritu to search for things. You can just ask Google to display the things by just talking the voice commands, like if you want to search for his other works, and Google displays his other works. That's how OK Google chain search works. You can search for anything in a continuous way or in a chain based manner just by saying the words. Combined words or single words, you can search for anything in the world, and Google knows everything, by the way. There is not even a single thing which Google is not aware of. Google even knows who really the Batman is. Yes. And that's pretty much it with the OK Google voice assisted search. So now let us move on to the next part, and that involves time and weather commands. Google time and weather commands allows you to get time based results and weather based results. In case if you want to find the time of a place, the weather of a place, the current weather of your place, the predicted weather of your place for the next 2 days, for the next week, for the next month, and things like that. If you ask Google, as OK Google, what's the time now, it will display the time. When will the sunset, it will display the sunset time for that day. And predictions. Everything is predictions collected from the weather stations and other things. And if you want to wake up early in the morning before sunrise, then ask, okay Google, when will the sun rise tomorrow?
The sun will rise at 5:58 a.m.
If you are moving on to other countries or other continents, and if you want to get details about the time zone of those places, you can even ask about what's the time there, what's the time here, and things like that. And when coming to weather commands, this is really an useful feature. But when it comes to weather commands, you can get informations like what is the current weather situation, what will be the weather 2 days later, a month later, the next week. The voice commands are simple, like the time thing. You can ask Google as, okay Google, will it rain today or will it rain tomorrow? How's the weather today? Show me the weather for 2 days. How will be the weather on Tuesday, Thursday, and things like that. It's pretty much simple. And even if you wanna know, if you are, let's consider you are going to play outside and you don't know whether it will be raining then, or you don't know how the weather is actually. So in case if you want to take your umbrella or raincoat, then just ask Google, okay Google, do I need an umbrella today? And it will display the results about the weather forecast, will it rain today or not, and it's accurate. So far I have tested, it's accurate. That's how the voice commands work. If you want to search about California's weather, New York's weather, just ask Google, okay Google, how will be the weather in New York on Thursday? Whichever location you want to search for, just say the voice commands, say it, Google will show it. That's all with this time and weather based commands. So now let us move on to the next thing. This thing will be really a helpful one for you, because most of us use Google Maps and voice navigation systems for getting directions. Now and then, if you are moving from one place to another place which is unknown to you, and using OK Google, you can make it simple just like that. So let's see about the maps, the navigation commands, the navigation and map voice commands appeared by OK Google. You can get directions from your place to other places by saying the command, OK Google, show me directions from this place to another, or simply show me directions to the place where you want to go. Google automatically scan or find your location, your current location, and it will navigate you to your destination location. You can find any routes. It will show the map section by going inside Google Maps. You can get a clear view of how to travel from one place to another. And this also helps you to navigate from one place to another. Just ask Google to navigate and it will open Google Map Navigation. Even in case if you want to find the distance from one place to another, just ask Google, okay Google, show me the distance from my place to that place, and it will show the distance, accurate distance. And that's pretty much it with the map and navigation, okay Google voice commands. So let us move on to the next thing, and that thing is really a cool thing, and it lets you to set alarms, reminders, notes, schedules, events in just a command. You can ask Google, Google, wake me after 2 hours, and it will set the alarm right away, and it will wake you after 2 hours by beeping the alarm sound. That's how the alarm and reminder systems work. So let's have a look at those things. First, let us start by making or creating an alarm. Okay Google, wake me after 3 hours.
Okay, 2:51 p.m. setting your alarm.
And Google sets an alarm, and it will sound the alarm exactly after the hours you are specified. And in case if you want to make a note, Google has two apps to make notes, Google Keep and Gmail. You can just ask Google, okay Google, make me a note or make a note, and it will open the apps which are available in your device. If you want to go with Google Keep, or if you want to go with Google Mail or Gmail, just say the words and Google will make a note for you. The most coolest feature here is, if you want to remind about something, if you are a short-term memory loss person like me, I forget everything. I forget to complete my assignments, I forget to complete my homeworks, forget to study for my exams. It's like a problem, it's like a disease to me. I hate those things. So if I want to remember those things, I will ask Google, okay Google, remind me about my exams. on the date or after 2 hours or the time at which you want to be reminded about, things like that. Just say the words and Google will sound the reminder for you. And you can even access the timer and countdown timer using Google voice commands. If it is useful, just say Google, okay Google, countdown for 10 seconds or start the timer for 20 minutes, 10 minutes. It can even add an event or schedule to your Google calendar. It will automatically sync that with the Google calendar and it will sound the alarm when the event is gonna happen or the time when you have scheduled the event for. It's simple and it's cool. That is all with the timer, notes, reminder, clocks, alarms and things. So now let us move on to the next thing, that is device control commands. Using OK Google, you can control your device to some extent. Using voice commands, you can perform some actions which can control your device. When it comes to device control commands, you can adjust the sound, the brightness, you can open an app, you can do things like playing a song and things like that. If you want to adjust the brightness, just ask Google, OK Google, set the brightness to 10, 8, 9 on a scale of 1 to 10. It actually modifies your brightness and the same way your sound do. If you want to open up your camera, if you want to take a selfie, ask Google, OK Google, take a selfie and it will take the selfie. If you want to record a video, just say Google, OK Google, record a video for me. It's simple. Just voice things. And in case if you want to open an app, just say the words, OK Google, open Twitter, or OK Google, open WhatsApp or Snapchat, Instagram. It will open it. And in case even if you want to perform some operations like turning on your flashlight, turning off your flashlight, so just say Google, OK Google, turn on flashlight. It will turn on your flashlight, turn off the flashlight and it will do just in a second. And the next thing, playing songs or opening playlist. Google can play you songs or play songs from your playlist if you say the right commands. If you are having more than one or two or three music apps, then you have to specify the app name too if you want to play a song. So I think I took a long time with this thing. So let's move on to the next thing, and the next thing is actually a boring thing and I hate it because it involves mathematics and things. There are two things I hate the most in the world. The first thing is waking up early on Sunday mornings and the second thing is mathematics. No offense, I hate Max. This Google's mathematical calculations and conversions are real hands-free thing. If you want to calculate a value or convert a value from one form to another, you need not access your physical calculator or calculator app in device. Instead, just say the voice commands and Google will do the magic for you. Or just say, OK Google, what is 2 plus 3? What is 235 plus 345? What is 2 cross 6? And even complex mathematical operations can be performed using OK Google mathematical calculator. Or not only mathematical calculations, Google is also capable of converting values from one unit to another. If you want to convert centimeters to inches, inches to feet, it can convert values from one unit to other unit just in a glimpse. I'm not gonna take much time in this. I hate Max, so let us move on to the next thing. And the next thing involves some fun facts, and there's things are called as Easter eggs. Google is the master of Easter eggs. Google has lots and lots of Easter eggs packed inside it, and it can be accessed using voice commands. Google recently added two games which you can play. Recently they added tic-tac-toe game, and let's play that game. X goes there. It's actually in medium difficulty mode, as you can see there. Oh yeah, take that Google, I win. Machine versus man, and man wins the race. That's how our universe works. I own. There are even lots and lots of things like searching for a status of a flight or getting informations about stock market and business things. If you are a stock market type person and if you want to get information about day-to-day stock values or stock rises, drops, stock of a company, stock status of an organization, just say the words to Google and Google will turn the results for you. Lots and lots of things are left unexplored inside this Google's voice search assistant. And it's really bad and not fair if you are not using this thing. So just have fun around with this thing. Just say the words, get the results, using this thing you can impress a lot of people, if you know what I mean. That's all with the voice command supported by OK Google. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did so, give me a like. If you didn't so, give me a dislike as usual. If you have any suggestions, leave it as comments. If you want to stay connected with my channel, stay subscribed. If you are already a subscriber, then thank you for subscribing. I'll hopefully meet you guys in the next one. Until and unless, it's bye bye from ATS Stars. Bye.